right, if I may have everybody's attention, we'd like to direct your attention to the entrance to the ballroom. Parents of the groom, Mike and Patsy Goodman, give them a round of applause. All right, my door operator wasn't ready yet. Mike and Patsy Goodman, now to the round of applause. Parents of the bride, Bernie and Lori Farrow. Ushers, Matt Clemmy and Matt Stepankiewicz. Groomsman, Craig Goodman, escorting bridesmaid, Chloe Pierce. Groomsman, Kevin Goodman, escorting bridesmaid, Allie May Lou. Groomsman, Brad Butler, escorting bridesmaid, Demi Johnson. Groomsman, Steve Dow, escorting bridesmaid, Christina Jones. Katie Fox, escorted by ring bearer Brock Clemmy. Best man, Brady Hughes, escorting matron of honor, Stephanie Stepankiewicz. Gentlemen, if you'd please rise, direct your attention to the balcony and welcome Mr. and Mrs. Casey and Michelle Goodman. Another round of applause for Casey and Michelle Goodman. May be seated, with the exception of Casey and Michelle. At this time, they're going to have their first slow dance together.
Like a rainy Sunday morning makes me want to stay in bed, twisted up all day long. You're my inspiration, girl. You take me places, put the words right into songs. Stealing kisses undercover, babe. See forever when I see your face. And I swear God made you for me. You make it easy. Loving up on you. Make it easy with every little thing you do. You're my sunshine in the darkest.
Mr. and Mrs. Casey and Michelle Goodman. And if all of you would help me welcome Father of the Bride, Bernie Farrell.
Thank you. Good evening. Lori and I would like to welcome and thank everyone for joining us this evening. A year ago, this couple had to make a difficult decision to postpone their wedding. And I'm not even going to mention why, but you all know what I'm talking about. Most fathers only have to deal with the side effects of a wife and daughter planning a wedding for 1 year. I had to deal with this one for 2 long years. I didn't know you could talk about flowers 10 times the first year and another 10 the second year. Who knows? I might even get a home-cooked meal now and maybe even around the normal dinner hour. Seriously, we are so grateful to everyone for being here tonight to celebrate this special day for our daughter and her new husband. We truly have the best family and friends, and you being here means the world to both Lori and I. To Casey's parents, family, friends, and Michelle's friends, welcome. Thank you to everyone for joining us this evening. Michelle, you were beautiful today, and having that special first look with you meant the world to me. You are a beautiful bride. You've always made your mom and I very proud, and we couldn't be happier for you. As you start your new life, know that we will always be here for you. From the day you were born, you captured my heart, and you've always been our little girl. When you were born, your mom and I were excited to have another daughter. But I didn't know how much I was going to love the color pink and rhinestones. It has been an enjoyable and sometimes stressful watching you grow up from the little girl who'd love to teach school in our basement to twirling your batons and cheering for you at your pageants. And now, the beautiful, successful married woman you are today. I will always be in your corner. After all, you're my favorite teacher. You have a huge and caring heart with a touch of glitter, and I couldn't ask for a more special daughter. Don't ever lose your sparkle. Casey, Lori and I would like to welcome you into our family and want you to know all the rhinestones, glitter, and pink will soon be arriving at your house by the truckload. We are very proud of the young man Michelle has chosen. We are happy that you will be part of our family as we continue to convert you to a Notre Dame fan. Probably not in time for the ND-Purdue game this year, but it will happen. Seriously, we couldn't be happier for you and Michelle, and we wish you both a lifetime of happiness as you start your new life together. We will always be here for you, both. I want to thank the many individuals that have helped pull this together, and I won't even try to name them all, but the one person I do want to mention is my wife, Lori. Notice I didn't say thank Lori. Without Lori, nothing much happens around our house, and this wedding and reception has Lori's fingerprints all over it. It's truly amazing how she always manages to pull things together. So with that, please join me in a toast by raising your glasses for the first toast of the evening. To Michelle and Casey, we wish you both all the best and a lifetime of happiness. Cheers.
And now Pastor Kerry Clear is going to lead us in a blessing.
Well, thank you for that beautiful statement of encouragement and celebration of a beautiful family. Let us all close our eyes and join together in a prayer. Lord God, creator of the universe, we have gathered here in this room around our tables to celebrate the love and commitment that have united these two beautiful people in a wonderful bond of marriage. Bless our wonderful meal and bless the happy couple for a wonderful life together. Thank you for all the hands that have come together to make this happen. In Jesus' name, amen.
All right, if we could have everybody's attention at the head table, I'd like to introduce Stephanie, who is going to propose a toast.
Good evening to all of you guys. I want to welcome you to this beautiful wedding for Michelle and Casey. Hope you guys are all enjoying some of the drinks at the bar. You know, Casey's old fashions, Michelle's margaritas. We were generous enough to share the matron's drink with all of you. That's the ice water on all of your tables. Drink it up. For those of you who don't know me, I am Michelle's less sparkly, slightly shorter, completely hilarious older sister. Favorite older sister. Well, we finally made it to this night, and most of you probably don't know, my sister's been planning this night long before she was engaged. So thank you, Casey, for finally popping the question. Seriously, thank you. When I think back over the years, my sister's gone through many phases. The squeaky voice child that we love watching on our home videos. The kid who played school in the basement every chance she got, and man, was she strict. The teenager who thought she knew everything and tested everyone's limits. To the college kid who finally started to figure a few things out. And now, finally, a strong, confident woman who cares so much about Casey, her family, her friends, her career, and of course their dog Wrigley. As I mentioned earlier, I am Michelle's less sparkly sister, and anyone who knows me knows this is true to a T. We are polar opposites when it comes to our interests. I'm the sister who completely honors functionality over fashion. I like camping, hiking, fishing, and cold weather. My sister does pageants, drinks wine, very interested in the latest styles, and loves the sun. Even though we're very different, somehow we always found ways to be supportive of what the other person enjoyed doing. I've sat through hours and hours of twirling competitions and pageants that I will never understand. And I've even carried a giant sign with a picture of your face while you sat in the back of a convertible waving to crowds of people during a parade. I have learned more than I ever wanted to know about spray tans and hot rollers. You dreaded going on our family trip to Alaska like I wanted to do, but you went and you had fun, even though it was a little cold. You've gone to football games to see me in the marching band, and we've gone fishing, but usually only if we have Cheetos for bait. Maybe neither of us really wanted to do the same things, but we're always each other's biggest supporters. And deep down, we want to see the other person happy and successful. And I think we really both wanted to see if you could catch a fish with a Cheeto. We've gone through periods of hanging out and living together, to living miles away and not talking much at all. But whenever I needed my sister or wanted to talk, she was always there. Except the time in our apartment with the centipede that ran across the wall and the overflowing kitchen trash can that just magically filled up overnight. Even though she was able to tell me all about this giant bug that crawled across the wall, even though I was already asleep and in no way could make any trash, she apparently wasn't there for that. I would like to think that I was always there for you too. Obviously, somebody had to take care of that bug and take out the trash. At the very least, I'm the only person on this planet that understands Mom's craziness the way you do. Sisters are truly like best friends, and you can go for weeks, sometimes even months, without seeing each other. When you finally see each other again, it's like no time has even passed. We pick up right where we left off, talk about the most recent things our pets have done, and create new inside jokes. Casey, or should I say Casey Joe? You have your hands full, sir. First of all, I want to officially welcome you to the family. You're the brother I've always wanted but never had. I can't wait to take more pictures with you. But remember, it's one and done with me. Speaking of, is there a photographer anywhere we could grab a couple more pictures of this guy? I know how much he loves it. So, after one of Michelle's bridal showers, Casey and I got to talking, and I asked if he remembered the first time we ever met. We thought as hard as we could, but everything we thought of seemed too long after Michelle and Casey had first started dating. I had to have met Casey sooner than 2 years after they had been dating, right? Then I started to think about it a little more, and I realized, I don't think I can remember because Casey so seamlessly fits into our family. He walked straight into a family of jokesters and started throwing jabs right back. I think he truly belongs. One of the first memories I can think of with Casey was when we all took a family trip to the Bahamas. He was sharing the room next door with my now husband, Matt. We could hear him going on and on about family and how important it is. He and my sister may have been truly blissed at the time, and I know this because they spent the entire next day curled up under towels by the pool. But hearing everything Casey was saying really made me feel great about my sister's decision to be with Casey. I know you'll take care of her like she truly deserves. So everyone says that this right here is the best and happiest day of your life. You're in love, everything feels perfect. But what happens tomorrow? What happens in a few months or years down the road when things aren't brand new, not quite as fun and exciting, when work stretches you thin and when family stretches you out? Don't ever lose sight of what brought you together in the first place and the happiness that you share today. Sure, I said this is the best day of your life, but it can also be the best day of your life so far. And how do you do that? How do you make that happen? You continue to do things that make each other happy. This means venturing outside of your comfort zone a little bit. This means doing something you don't really want to do because you know it makes the other person happy. This means living in the moment with each other. Remember, sometimes it's not always about getting the perfect Instagram or Facebook-worthy picture. Take some time to realize where you are and who you're enjoying the moment with. I promise if you treat each other right and never go to bed angry, you guys are going to live a long, happy life together. Before I wrap things up, I want to let you know that Matt and I are always here for you guys to hang out with, to be loud and crazy with, to play euchre with, probably not to drink with because we're kind of old now, but we'll try to keep up. We want to see you both happy for many years to come. And I've got to be honest, hearing Michelle yell, Casey Joe, during cornhole is one of my favorite things in the world. So let's join in raising those glasses to the happy couple. Congratulations, Michelle and Casey. Cheers.
I read somewhere the perfect best man speech should only last as long as it takes for the groom to make love tonight, so that's it for me. For those who don't know me, my name is Brady Hughes. Casey and I have been friends for 25 plus years. To give a little background of Casey and I, we're just two kids who love to play sports. Some of my favorite memories include playing catch off the roof of his old house, diving football catches into his pool, or even trying to hit wiffle ball in the basement off Kevin. That never really worked out and always ended in Casey crying because Kevin threw too hard. As we got older, Brad, Casey, and I would ride electric scooters around Otterman. We played basketball before school each and every day. In the summer, we played home run derby. We're old enough, Brad, Casey, and I would drive, or Brad and I would drive Casey around because he was a little younger and couldn't drive. So oftentimes I had to pick Casey up from school, or Patsy would ask me to take Casey home after a football game because he had a concussion. The Goodmans have always treated me like family, though. Our dads coached together, took camping trips every year. Our moms spent hours on the phone every night. I don't really know what they were talking about, but it really interrupted our dial-up when I was trying to use it for AOL and chat with the chicks. But they always supported me. I can still hear Patsy cheering Francis in the Little League stands. And Mike was always there at 3 o'clock in the morning ready to grill a steak when I was pretty blackout drunk, so. Appreciate that, Mike. Now for Michelle. Did anybody else here know that Michelle was the first person in America with COVID? She lost taste in men 7 years ago when she met Casey. Michelle, you look beautiful tonight, and I couldn't think of a more beautiful bride for my best friend. Honestly, I didn't know if Michelle was going to make it. The first time I ever met her, we were at one of my other friends' weddings in college, and I had flown in from Virginia Beach. We decided to go to the campus bars in West Lafayette, and Michelle was puking out the side of the truck door. And all I could think to myself was, this girl wants to be a Goodman, and we got some work to do. But since that day, you've been nothing but proving yourself, and you've been great. Your family has been nothing but great, except me. I've been blacked out in a Notre Dame game, and they welcomed me in, so greatly appreciate it. But to wrap this up, thanks for being my best friend. From me playing third, you being at short, always being to my left, to living in college together and spending time after college, you've always been there for me. A couple weeks ago, I forgot my password to Facebook, and thank God it asked me who my childhood best friend was. So you're always there, even when you didn't know. But that's all I really got, so I just want to say thank you. Thanks for letting me be a part of your big day. Congratulations.
Casey and Michelle would like to turn your attention over to the cake. If you can't see from where you're at, you're more than welcome to get a little closer here. Over the dance floor, Michelle would like to share a dance with her father.
Dreams, but always know the road that'll lead you home again. know he's the half that makes you whole. He has a poet's soul and the heart of a man's man. You're beautiful, baby, from the outside in. Chase your dreams, but always know the road that'll lead you home again. Go on, take on this old world, but to me,
let's give Michelle and her father a round of applause. If we could have Casey and his mother.
Oh,
All right, for this next song, Casey and Michelle would like to invite all of you on the dance floor.
Well, I love a rainy night, I love a rainy night. I love to hear the thunder, watch the lightning when it lights up the sky. You know it makes me feel good. Well, I love a rainy night, such a beautiful sight. I love to feel rain on my face, taste the rain on my lips, in the moonlight shadows. Shadows wash all my cares away. I wake up to a sunny day, 'cause I love a rainy night. Yeah, I love a rainy night. Well, I love a rainy night. Well, I love a rainy night. Ooh, ooh, I love a rainy night. I love a rainy night. I love to hear the thunder, watch the lightning when it lights up.
All right, come on, everybody on the dance floor.
You know it makes me feel good. Well, I love a rainy night, it's such a beautiful sight. I love to feel the rain on my face, taste the rain on my lips, in the moonlight shadows. Puts a song in this heart of mine, puts a smile on my face every time, 'cause I love a rainy night. Yeah, I love a rainy night.
Thank you. Tool in his pants. Now my ladies, let me see it vibrate. And when it's over, you ain't gonna need your bird. Cause I'm a pro, make you bend your back low, then the pound it real bad, just like the percolate.
up in my taxi cab. Everybody's looking at me now. Like, who's that chick that's rocking kicks? She gotta be from out of town. So hard with my girls not around me. It's definitely not a Nashville party. Cause all I see is the letters. I guess I never got the memo. My tummy's turning and I'm feeling kinda homesick. Too much pressure and I'm nervous. It's when the DJ dropped my favorite tune.
I did it again. I played with your heart. sent you hallelujah. Girl sent you hallelujah. Girl sent you hallelujah. Cause Uptown Funk don't give it to you.
Here we go. for some action. But like Mick Jagger said, I can't get no satisfaction. The girls all want to rap, and but none of them want to get with me. My threads are fresh and I'm looking till you so what I want to say. Had the girls in the store, shocking, at the other end of the bar. Had a drink with some no lady chump, well they know that I'm a star. When I got a show was over, to the other side of cantina, I asked Casey why my eyes so blind, I said, fuck, come with me. You know what I'm saying? Oh yeah, you know what I'm saying. You guys know what I'm saying.
This brother told me a secret on how to get more chicks. Put a little Madeira in the glass and the girls will come real quick. It's a better than any alcohol, oh, aphrodisiac. A couple of sips of this love potion and she'll be on your lap. So I give some to my dog when he began to play. And then licked his bone and he looked at me and said the wild thing on my leg. He didn't scratch a bite me before he was much, much meaner. About all the poodles come to my house for the funky come with me. You know what I'm saying? Dog in my neighborhood breaking down my door. I got Spuds McKenzie, Alex from Strohs. They won't leave my dog alone without my data pile. Where's my little lady at? She said hi to my Jeep Descender. I thought she was good to go with a little funky. She said I like a drink. I said I'll pick it, I'll go get it. In a couple sips she gonna lick the lips and I knew that she was winning. So I kicked him to my crib, and everything went well as planned. Well, she got undressed and was a big old mess, just sitting there was a man. So I threw him up, I don't fool around with no Oscar Mayer wiener. You must be sure that your girl is pure for the funky comedy. You know what I'm saying? Ain't no playing with a man. This is the 80s and I'm going down with the ladies. No joke. Get an ass. Break it down. Yeah, now I gotta stop. I'm gonna hurt myself. I'm back in the saddle, looking for a little affection. And this song is good with all the love connection. The audience voted, and you know, they picked a winner. They took my date to Hilton for Madeira and some dinner. Yeah, had a few drinks. I thought we had enough pictures. They're talking about plans for Casey's wedding. Sounds like, sold out love, not so fast, well I'll be seeing ya. That's why I play, don't play around with a funky cold Madeira. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, my Madeira's on a monster. Get a Brocky flosser, baby. Now that's a floss.
Let's kick it. I sit back with my brand new invention. Something grabs a hold of me tightly. Flow like a hawk daily and nightly.
Will it ever stop?
Yo, I don't know. Turn off the lights and I glow. To the extreme, I rock a mic like a vandal. Light up a stage and wax a chump like a candle. Dance! Go rush the speaker that booms. I'm killing your brain like a poisonous mushroom. Deadly! When I play a dope melody, anything less than the best is a felony. Love it or leave it, you better gain weight. You better hit bullseye, the kid don't play. If there was a problem, yo, I'll solve it. Check out the hook while my DJ revolves it. MCs like a pound of bacon, burning them, being quick and nimble. I go crazy when I hear a symbol.